you please, band? Dear people of God, the first Christians observed with great devotion and godly discipline the days of our Lord's passion and resurrection. This season of Lent provided a time when those convicted of notorious sins were put to open penance and punished so that their souls will be saved on the last day. And it is also a time when those who, because of notorious sins, had been separated from the body of the faithful, were reconciled by penitence and forgiveness, and restored to the fellowship of the church. Others will be warned by the example and might be more afraid to offend or sin. Thereby, the whole congregation was put in mind of the message of pardon and absolution, and of the need which all Christians continually have to renew their repentance and faith. I invite you, therefore, in the name of God, to the observance of a holy Lent by self-examination and repentance, by prayer, fasting, and self-denial, and by reading and meditating on God's holy word, in order to make a right beginning of repentance and to affirm God's judgment upon sin. It is thought good that we be reminded of God's commandments. We should implore his mercy by answering amen as a sign of your assent to them. God is one. Those who do not worship him wholeheartedly, but worship idols, images, wealth, and have loyalty in cults and secret societies, God shall judge. God's name is holy. Those who blaspheme it and those who use it in vain, God shall judge. The Lord's day is holy. Do not neglect the coming together of the brethren for worship. Those who profane it, God shall judge. Honor your parents and elders, those who dishonor them, and they that are lawless and seditious, God shall judge. Do not commit murder. Those who bear grudges unforgivingly, and they that are malicious and cruel, God shall judge. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Those who commit adultery and all fornicators and lustful persons, God shall judge. All good works are God's work. Good works honor God. Those who steal and they who defraud others, God shall judge. Speak the truth at all times. Those who bear false witness and all who lie and speak evil of others, God shall judge. Honor the property of others. Those who covet, extort, and oppress others, God shall judge. Love your neighbors as yourself. Witches and wizards, sorcerers, and those who work against the good of their neighbors, God shall judge. Let us kneel. We shall read Psalm 51 together reverently. Psalm 51 together reverently. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your loving kindness. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses. Wash me thorough and true and true from my wickedness, and cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions, and my sins is ever before me. Against you have I sinned, and done what is evil in your sight. So you are justified when you speak and upright in your judgment. Indeed, I have been wicked from my birth, a sinner from my mother's womb. For behold, you look for truth deep within me, or will make me understand wisdom secretly. Purge me from my sin, and I shall be pure. Wash me, and shall be made clean indeed. Make me hear of joy and gladness. By the body you have broken, may rejoice. Hide your face from my sins, and blot out all my iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me. Give me the joy of your saving help again, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit. I shall teach your ways to the wicked, and sinners shall return to you. Deliver me from death, O God, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness. O God of my salvation, open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise. Had you desired it, I would have offered sacrifice, but you take no delight in burnt offerings. Voice of God is a troubled spirit, a broken and contrite heart. O God, you will not despise. Be favorable and gracious to Zion, and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Then you will be pleased with the appointed sacrifices, with burnt offerings and oblations. Unto the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Christ, have mercy upon us. Our Father, that in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. O Lord, save your people. Send them help from above. Help us, O Lord, our Savior. O Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord, we pray you mercifully to hear our prayers and spare those who have confessed their sins to you, that those whose consciences accuse them of sin may, by your merciful pardon, be absolved through Christ our Lord. O most mighty God and Father of mercy, you show compassion upon all people and do not hate anything you have made. You do not desire that any sinner should perish, but that he may turn from his sin and be saved. In your mercy, forgive us our evil ways. Receive and comfort us who are grieved and wearied with the burden of our sins. You alone can show mercy. You alone can forgive sins. Save us, good Lord. Save your people whom you have redeemed. Do not enter into judgment with us. Mercifully turn your anger from us who are truly penitent, and so make haste to help us now, that we may always live with you in the world to come, through Christ our Lord. Together Lord, show us your favor as we turn to you, weeping, fasting, and praying. You are a good God of mercy, full of compassion, long-suffering, and of great pity. Your pardon even when we deserve to be punished. And in your justice, you show mercy. Save us, good Lord. Let not be confused. Hear us, O Lord, for your mercy is great. In your mercy upon us, through the merits and meditation of your blessed Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Májẹ̀mú láéláé fún ìsìyí láò rí nínú ìwé Jóẹ́lì orí kejì bẹ̀rẹ̀ kíkà láti ẹsẹ̀ kejìlá. Ǹjẹ́ nítorí náà nísìsiyí ni Olúwa wí, ẹ fi gbogbo ọkàn yín yí padà sí mi àti pẹ̀lú ààwẹ̀ àti pẹ̀lú ẹkún àti pẹ̀lú ọ̀fọ̀. Ẹ sì fa aya yín ya, kìí sì ṣe aṣọ yín. Ẹ sì yí padà sí Olúwa Ọlọ́run yín, nítorí tí ó pọ̀ ní oore ọ̀fẹ́, ó sì kún fún àánú, ó lọ́ra láti bínú, ó sì ṣeun púpọ̀, ó sì ronúpìwàdà láti ṣe búburú. Ta ni ó mọ̀ bí òun yóò yí padà kí ó sì ronúpìwàdà, kó sì fi ìbùkún sílẹ̀ lẹ́yìn rẹ̀, àní ọrẹ jíjẹ àti ọrẹ mímu fún Olúwa Ọlọ́run yìí. Ẹ fún ìpè ní Sioni, ẹ ya ìjọsí mímọ́, ẹ pe àjọ tí ó ní ìrọ̀rùn. Ẹ kó àwọn ènìyàn jọ, ẹ ya ìjọsí mímọ́, ẹ pe àwọn àgbàjọ, ẹ kó àwọn ọmọdé jọ àti àwọn tí mu omi. Jẹ́ kí ọkọ ìyàwó jáde kúrò ní ìyàrá rẹ̀ àti ìyàwó kúrò nínú ìyàrá rẹ̀. Jẹ́ kí àwọn àlùfà, àwọn ìránṣẹ́ Olúwa sọkún láàrin ìloro àti pẹpẹ, sì jẹ́ kí wọ́n wí pé dá àwọn ènìyàn rẹ sí Olúwa, má sì ṣe fi ìní rẹ fún ẹ̀gàn tí àwọn kèfèrí yóò fi máa jọba lórí wọn. Èṣe tí wọn ó fi wí nínú àwọn ènìyàn pé Ọlọ́run wọn há da. Èyí ni ọ̀rọ̀ Olúwa.
Testament reading shall be taken in the book of Matthew, chapter 6, commencing reading from verse 16. Moreover, when you fast, be not as hypocrites of a sad countenance, for they have disfigured their face, that they may appear unto men to fast. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou fastest, anoint their head and wash their face, that thou appear not unto men to fast, but unto the Father, which is in the secret, and their Father, which seeth in secret, shall reward them openly. Lay not up for yourself the treasure upon the head, where moth and rust don't corrupt, and where thief break through and steal. But lay up for yourself the treasure in heaven, where neither moth nor rust don't corrupt, and where thief do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. This is the word of God.
Baba wa ti Olorun wa gidigidi la fi ope la fi ya ti ogo fun o nitori pe o se o nitori ti anu re duro lai lai adupe fun ibere otun e to tun fi ba wa bere ni akoko lenti papa julo fun ojo oni ti a mo se Wednesday eru e to bere irin ajo ogoji osan ati ogoji oru gege bi Jesu Kristi olugbala wa ti fi ilana re lele fun wa baba a fi o siwaju baba ma je ka se lasan ni pari irin ajo yi baba aye ni kene no wa ma je ko sofo ijoba orun re ta nle pa baba ma je ko bo sonu lowo wa o an lo sinu oro re oluwa ba wa so fun wa ni eti igbo fun alaya igba se adupe po ti gbo ti wa Jesu Kristi oluwa wa We return all thanks to God Almighty for bringing us to Ash Wednesday in the year 2024. And may his name continue to be glorified forever and ever in the mighty name of Jesus. Ash Wednesday is the church Yom Kippur or Day of Atonement. The very name of the day comes from the ancient practice of mourning or doing penance, wearing sackcloth and putting on ashes to express penitence, not only by the chosen people, but by pagans as well. The Old Testament shows us the pagan people of Nineveh and the Jewish queen Esther, just to mention a few, all of whom fasted. They put on sackcloth and they put on ashes. In the early church, Christians who have committed serious sins did public penance, wearing sackcloth and ashes. And we had a replica of what happened then, in line with what our Father in the Lord, the Venerable K.K. Ogundile, did for us when we had communion in the course at the beginning of this service. The church instructs us to observe Ash Wednesday and Good Friday as days of full fast and abstinence. Fasting is prescribed to reinforce a penitential prayer during the Lenten season. In our first reading, Prophet Joel insists that we should experience a complete conversion of heart. And Psalm 51, in the combination service for today, provides us with an excellent prayer of repentance and a plea for forgiveness. Why Jesus, in the New Testament reading, Matthew Gospel chapter 6, verses 16 to 21, encourage us not to show off when we are fasting for people to praise us. I will still get back to the readings later in the course of this service. The blessing of the ashes and the significance of the day. The priest dipping his thumb into the ashes collected from palms from the previous year's Palm Sunday marks the forehead of each with the sign of the cross, saying, "Remember that you are dust, and to dust you shall return." Or repent and believe in the gospel. By doing this, the church gives us more information. One, we are mortal beings. You may be the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. You may be the Archbishop of Africa. You may be the prelate. You may be the primate. You may be the vicar of this church. Whoever you are, remember that you are what? A mortal being. What guides us through is the grace of God that we have. Two, our bodies will become dust when buried. When we are cremated, what comes out from cremation? Ashes. And that tells you and I that there is nothing in this world. We are being reminded that come back, oh my son, come back, oh my daughter, before it is too late. I pray that it will not be too late for us in the mighty name of Jesus. So let us try as much as possible, wherever we find ourselves. Do you know who I am? Who are you? I am not your mate. If you want to know your mate, go to Arthur Cemetery. Hello? You have a lot of people there. Billionaires of this world. People with fantastic brain set. They are there. Guard the opportunity that you have while alive. Live well. Serve well. Touch lives. Number three, our lifespan is very brief and unpredictable. You see somebody in the morning, don't be surprised in the evening. What about that man? Oh, sorry. It has happened. What has happened? He's gone. She's gone. And that is why the psalmist plead that God grant us grace to number what? Our day, so as to be what? To be able to appropriate our lives accordingly. Because time and tide wait for no man. Do what you can do now. Make the necessary changes. Make the positive impact now. Because the opportunity may not represent itself again. This Lenten season affords us the opportunity to draw closer to God by total repentance of our sins, become reconciled with God, asking for his pardon and forgiveness so that we can renew our life as the prodigal son did. The prodigal son squandered the wealth of his father. But at the point when he came back to his senses, why am I suffering? Even the least of my father's servants lives in what? In luxury. What stops me from going back home? And we can see how his father, representing God, welcomed him with an open hand. God is willing. God is ready to accept us. But we must also take that bold step of faith by doing what? Come back to him. Brethren in the Lord, we need to purify and renew our lives, not only during this Lenten season, expressing our sorrow for our sins by turning away from the near occasion of sins and making a right turn to God. We express our repentance by becoming reconciled with God daily, by asking for forgiveness from those we have offended, and by giving unconditional forgiveness to those we have offended or those who have offended us, and by receiving the sacrament of reconciliation. Jesus Christ said, if you forgive, you will also receive what? Forgiveness. Those people that you have tied down, go and release them. Help me turn to the person by your side. Go and release those who have tied down. Those that we have promised that even if my forefathers should come down now, I will not forgive him. I will not forgive her. Beloved in the Lord, you are also retaining your own forgiveness. You are telling God, don't forgive me. Following the example of Jesus before his public ministry, fasting reduces our spiritual obesity. I can't do without taking this. I can't do without drinking it. It helps us to reduce our spiritual obesity or the excessive accumulation of fat in our soul. Talking about every evil tendencies, all evil habits, all evil addictions, fasting helps us to tone down. Fasting gives us additional moral and spiritual strength and encourages us to share our blessings with the needy. Pe ki a gbiyanju lati sore fun awon ti ko ni. Ipe ki a gbiyanju lati nawo si awon elomiran. Ipe ka gbiyanju lati sore fun awon ti ko le san fun wa pada. Akoko ta wa ni isin ni yen. Kesi akoko kagbawe nikan ko ma si ise rere kankan lowo wa. This season offers us more time to be with God in prayer. Joel chapter 2 verse 13 says, rend your heart and not your garments. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and abounding in love, and he relents from sending calamity. The above verse leads us to a big question. What kind of fasting does God require? If you turn your Bibles with me to Isaiah chapter 58. Isaiah chapter 58, if you all have our Bibles here, I wouldn't mind, or better still, if you have it on OHP, you can help us fly it. Isaiah chapter 58, verses 6 to 7. I want us to read it together. Are we there? Isaiah chapter 58, verses 6 to 7. Okay? It's not this kind of fasting I have chosen, to loose the chains of injustice and untie the what? The cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and break every yoke? Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter? When you see the naked, to clothe him, and not to turn away from your own flesh and blood. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, when I was hungry, you fed me. When I was thirsty, you gave me water. When I was homeless, you provided shelter for me. They were curious. Master, when did we see you going hungry? Our Lord Jesus Christ said, inasmuch as you have what? You have done it for these ones. We have so many around us groping from morning till evening without food. We have people who are ready or should I say who are prone to react to what shouldn't have pushed them to make any kind of reaction. To ba telomin lese mole loni nigba kan to ba se pele ani don't bother abi loni to ba ti telese mole o ma gbe gbaju fun e to rara nkan ibi npa. That is the level, that is the situation we find ourselves now. And the same people, God, through his servants, is telling us, make sure that you make impact, positive impacts in the lives of these worlds. The have-not around us. Àwọn tó ń bá wa ṣiṣẹ́, àwọn ọmọ ọ̀dọ́ wa, ká má ṣe wọ́n bí ìgbà pé kò ń ṣe nìkan ló bí wọn. Kìí ṣe àkókò Lent nìkan ní gbogbo ọjọ́. Nítorí pé kíni, ẹlẹ́dàá wọn ń wò wá, a lè san ní kálukú wa ní kíni o, bí iṣẹ́ ọwọ́ wa ti rí. Today is Valentine's Day. Abi, what a big coincidence. It is obvious that if you spell Valentine, you cannot spell Valentine without Lent. Am I right? Valentine. What do you have there? You have Lent. And we talk about Valentine, we are talking about love, Abby. Let's go out and share love with others. Let's share love to them. The miserables among us, let's share love to them. Let's encourage them, because it is no longer advisable for you to tell whoever cares to listen that, do you know, brother, do you know, sister, that Jesus is love? Beloved, you have to do what? You have to practicalize it, though, if that your God is love. And that is what God Almighty wants us to do. That's why our Lord Jesus Christ laid himself free of charge for us on the cross of Calvary. Sacrificial giving. The same thing is encouraging us to go and do likewise. God loves us. And we are also expected to do likewise. If you love me, you will not cheat me. Am I right? You will not snatch my wife. Am I in order? I will not also snatch your husband. If you love me, I will not be targeting your body parts to sell. If you love me, if I love you, I will not pocket your sweat. Ron baba wa lo so be bibeli papa so won ni oya alagbase o se kini melo melo opolopo wa ta nfi oya won ta fi ndu won bamu bamu ni mo yo emi o mo pe bi nse kini omo enikan kan loruko Jesu oluwa oni fi wa wa be wa wo mi o gbo ami yen dada mo set yin up ni o. You must do the work behind it. If that army will be meaningful, it goes beyond saying army. Oni reje o si ninu kini o ko si ninu photo to ba se duro lo se ma se kini o ba kun powder si bi kegbe bi bai ko ma se powder nbe to ba ma jade kilo ma ri nbe. As you lay your bed, so you lie. Jesu npe wa ipe ni akoko yi ninu eko keji wa ireti Matthew ori kefa ese kani ni logun Matthew chapter 6 verse 16 o wi pe nigbati e ba n gba awe e ma se bi awon alase on ti won ma fajuro ki awon eniyan le ri loju won pe won se kini won gba awe mo fe ki e mo daju daju pe won ti gba ere won ni ekun rere akoko lent ki se akoko ifebe panu lasan is not a period for hunger strike agbodo kun fun ise rere ife ni kini o akoja ofin ki se lenu lasan agbọlọ ma bira wa lere kini mo le se lati fi ran awon eniyan wonyi lowo enikan ju nkan si mi o lo sodo ya olonje kan mo ma popolopo wa na lati ma ri oni madam awon nje yi elo ni onje yi ma to ah awon resi ti mo se yi ah o ma to 35,000 oloke mo ma ra gbogbo e ah iro o o ti fun mi lowo gan ba mo se ma gbo fe ra gbogbo e o se pe madam relax oni ko tele ohun o gbe ya olonje sinu bus ato nje atobe ati gbogbo e won lo si abe bridge oni ko ma serve awon ti won sun nbe ti bi npa e wa ma wu awon ti bi npa bi won se njo iwo ati mi na mo wi pe en te bi npa ko se kini ko gbo waasu nigbati ya olonje de ta onje fun won ton oni ya olonje elo lo npo onje 35,000 o fun ni 100,000 elo onje ni shekin kunle ni ya olonje n sadura oni ya olonje ma worry oni pe bo ti e pi e eru oba e o tele mi lo lati lo pin si onje fun awon elomiran o tun fun ni additional 50,000 kini ti mo so ni pe that man made the day of those people that we refer to as dregs of the society. They have not. Ara mi ninu Oluwa opo oro ko agbon on ta n pe wa fun lakoko yi ni practical Christianity. O le ma juko bi owo gari lo o mo le gba emi elomiran la awon right standard si waste bin awon eyan wa laje ka wa ta je ku ta le fun won pure water ti okun e loju yen gold mine ni felomi awon iyato ti a n pe wa lati se lakoko yi niyan ko n se fun awe lasan ise gbolo won ni igbagbo laisi ise kini won pe oku ni beloved I'm encouraging us to change our style this Lenten season. Let's be more practical. Lakoko yi jake jado da osisi wa a ma soro fun wa lori onje ale oluwa pataki re ni ife ti jesu to fi ko awon eyin re jo pe lati mo ninu ago kan na ki lo mu eniyan lati ri pe emi ati wo a mu wine ninu ago kan na kini o ife ni onje ale oluwa o ni ona si igbalo kan wa onje ale oluwa o fun ni ni okun ati iwosan ti a n ri gba ninu re gbogbo awon nkan won yi la ma ma tu wele wele fun wa ba se n lo lawon ojojo onje okan re o gbogbo tabi o wuwo ni akoko yi jesu n pe o pe wa sodo mi darapo ma awon omo leyin mi ke jo fowo papo sise ke mu opolopo wa sinu agbo mi mo de gbadura pe lakoko lenti ya ati leyin lenti yi oluwa je ko ro wa lorun o mo ne ko ni le mo wa o je ka gbadura. I want you to talk to God the Father, help me to be more practical. iṣẹ́ ti dílẹ̀ fún wa. There's no none of us that cannot do something. Kò sẹ́ni nínú wa tí ó lè ṣe nǹkan. That 5 naira, that 10 naira, that 50 naira. To some, nǹkan ńlá ni. Jẹ́ ká gbàdúrà kí Olúwa kó ràn wá lọ́wọ́. Pé nínú eré ìje ìgbàgbọ́ yìí, ká má ṣe ṣubú dànù. And so, Father, we return all thanks to you because of your faithfulness. Thank you because we know that more than we could ever imagine, you are going to surprise us. That, Lord God Almighty, every grace needful to touch lives for you, you will grant unto us. Thank you for answering us. In Jesus' name we pray.
As we sing the next hymn on page 6, we shall take collection.
Giver of all, we thank you for the gift of life, and we thank you for this season. Thank you for the privilege to give our offering unto you, this collection. We pray that you accept us, accept this offering as offering of sweet-smelling aroma. And may it attract more of your grace, more of your love, more of your provision upon us throughout this season and beyond. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we humbly pray you to spare those who are penitent and to be merciful to those who call upon you. Vouchsafe to send your Holy Spirit power from heaven to bless and sanctify these ashes that they may be a wholesome medicine to all who devoutly call upon your holy name and who bewail their sin in the sight of your divine compassion, humbly and earnestly imploring your bountiful loving kindness, and grant that by the calling on your most holy name, all who are sprinkled therewith for the remission of their sins may receive both healing of body and protection of soul. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord, bless these ashes to our use and grant that they may remind us of our mortality and of our need of repentance, so that we may keep Lent faithfully in preparation for the joy of Easter. We ask this in the name of Christ, our Lord. Lord be with you. We turn to page 8. And we shall take the next prayer together. Set free, O God, our souls from all restlessness and anxiety. Give us that peace and power which flow from you. Save us from all perplexities and distresses, in all fears and unfaithfulness, so that upheld by your power and stayed on the rock of your faithfulness, we may through storm and stress abide in you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Unto God's gracious mercy and protection we commit you. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the blessings of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you now and forever. Lord be with you. Once again, we return our thanks to God Almighty for making this day glorious for us, the first day in Lent. And I pray that he who has started with us will surely enable us all to finish strong in Jesus' name. I'd like to appreciate members of the Guild of Stewards, our Director of Music, all your fathers and mothers, our uncles. Thank you very much for coming. God will continue to bless us all in Jesus' name. The ICT crew, we appreciate you as sound engineer. God bless us all, the sextons as well as the cleaners for adding value to this service. God bless you in Jesus' name. And to some of our visitors who are worshiping with us for the first time, and those who connect with us online, God will continue to bless us all in Jesus' name. I'd like to appreciate Mrs. Awunuga from St. John's Anglican Church, Arrow Lawyer. Thank you very much. She has been a big sister to us. And also Mr. Doyin Owolabi from Cathedral Church of St. Jude, Butemecha. I know that we have a lot others in the house. God recognizes you, and may he continue to bless us all in Jesus' name. Please, we are back again next week, Wednesday. The service starts at 5:30. And I'd like to encourage you, all our fathers and mothers, our uncles, and everybody that has served in our envelope, please. We know that our tradition in this church, we collect on Wednesday, and we also collect on Sundays. So that is what we are going to be running. And we pray that as we give, God Almighty will continue to bless us in return in Jesus' name. But please, especially this year, we are going to do it better for God. Can you help me tell the person by your side? Let us do it better for God this year. I can't hear you. Thank you very much. That is the spirit. Yes, we are going to fast and we are going to back it up with action. And God will continue to help us out in Jesus' name. Thank you very much. Adelilayo, appreciate it.